Picture this, Las Vegas, 1996, a night that would etch itself into the annals of hip-hop history and fuel countless conspiracy theories for decades to come. The evening of September 7, 1996, was one of electrifying energy and anticipation. The city of Sin was alive with the pulsating rhythm of a Mike Tyson fight at the MGM Grand. Among the high-profile spectators was Tupac Shakur, a name that had become synonymous with West Coast rap, and a figure who was no stranger to controversy. The night was young and full of promise. Tupac, charismatic and vibrant, had just witnessed Tyson's victory. As the crowd roared and the adrenaline coursed, he left the arena, unaware that these were the final moments of normalcy he would experience. The neon-lit streets of Las Vegas were a spectacle, a maze of glitz and glamour. Tupac, along with Shug Knight, CEO of Death Row Records, made their way to the black BMW that was to ferry them to their next destination, Club 662. It was here that the night took a dark and unexpected turn. Stopped at a red light on Flamingo Road, just a few hundred yards from the Strip, a white Cadillac pulled up alongside the BMW. In a blink of an eye, a rapid succession of gunshots rang out, piercing the cool desert air. The music and laughter that had filled the night were replaced by the chilling sound of sirens and the harsh reality of violence. Tupac Shakur, the man who had given voice to the struggles of the streets, who had risen to the zenith of the music world, was now slumped in the passenger seat, riddled with bullets. The bright lights of Vegas had been overshadowed by a dark cloud of uncertainty. Emergency services arrived, racing against time to save the life of one of hip-hop's most iconic figures. But the damage was done. The bullets had found their mark, and Tupac was rushed to the University Medical Center of Southern Nevada. And as the sun rose over Las Vegas the next morning, Tupac Shakur lay in a hospital bed, fighting for his life. But to understand the significance of that night, we need to rewind a bit. In the early 90s, two figures were rising to prominence in the hip-hop industry. Tupac Shakur, a West Coast rapper with a poetic soul, and Sean Combs, better known as Diddy, an East Coast music mogul with a flair for fashion and a knack for business. These two were set to leave an indelible mark on the music scene, and for a time they were friends. Tupac, the son of a Black Panther, was unapologetically political in his lyrics, giving voice to the struggles of African Americans. His talent was undeniable, and his charisma magnetic. Diddy, on the other hand, was the mastermind behind Bad Boy Records, the label that introduced us to the notorious Big. He was the embodiment of the American dream, a man who built an empire from nothing. In the beginning, there was mutual respect between the two. Tupac was even set to sign with Bad Boy Records at one point. But the winds of the music industry are fickle, and soon, a rivalry was born. The exact cause of this feud is hard to pin down. Some say it was over business disputes, while others point to personal betrayals. The stakes were high and the competition fierce. Both Tupac and Diddy were ambitious men, hungry for success. Their rivalry was fueled by their desire to be the best, to dominate the charts, and to leave a lasting legacy in the world of hip-hop. They used their music as a battleground, with each new track serving as a salvo in their ongoing war. What started as a friendly competition quickly spiraled into something much darker. The rivalry was no longer just about music. It was about power, influence, and survival in an industry that often chewed up and spat out its brightest stars. Soon, this rivalry would escalate, culminating in a tragic event that still remains shrouded in mystery. The stage was set for a feud that would divide the hip-hop world. This wasn't just a war of words, it was a clash of titans, a contest of coasts. The East Coast-West Coast feud, as it came to be known, was more than just Tupac Shakur and Diddy at loggerheads. It was an ideological battle, a cultural rift, a territorial dispute draped in rhythm and rhyme. On one side, you had Tupac Shakur, charismatic, outspoken, and unapologetically West Coast. He was the embodiment of the rugged, raw, and rebellious spirit of the West, his lyrics echoing the struggles and stories of those from his side of the country. On the other side was Diddy, the face of the East Coast. He was polished, sophisticated, and business-minded. His music had a different flavor, a different rhythm. It was the sound of the city, the pulse of the streets, the heartbeat of the East. The feud between these two giants was not born in a day. It was a slow burn, a fire stoked by a series of incidents that kept adding fuel to the flames. There was the infamous Quad Studios shooting in New York, where Tupac was shot 5 times. Tupac accused Diddy's associates of setting him up, a claim that was never proven but served to intensify the feud. Then came the diss tracks, the public spats, the media frenzy. Each incident, each exchange, each barb thrown only served to deepen the divide, to harden the lines drawn in the sand. This feud wasn't just about Tupac and Diddy, it was about two coasts, two ideologies, two styles of music. It was about identity and belonging, about pride and prejudice. It was a feud that was played out in the public eye, on the airwaves, and in the hearts and minds of hip-hop fans across the world. The tension was at an all-time high. Little did anyone know, it was about to reach a deadly climax. Back to that fateful night in Las Vegas. The city was humming with energy, the bright lights casting long, mysterious shadows. The evening of September 7, 1996, was just like any other evening, until it wasn't. Tupac Shakur, one of the most influential figures in hip-hop, was on his way to a night of celebration after a Mike Tyson fight. Little did he know, this night would be his last. As the red traffic light held them back, a white Cadillac pulled up. A cascade of gunfire erupted, hitting Tupac multiple times. Within a week, the world had lost a hip-hop icon. But let's rewind a bit, back to the moments before the gunfire. The air was thick with tension, and not just because of the boxing match. Rumors and whispers had been swirling around Tupac and his entourage all evening. A certain figure was named repeatedly, adding fuel to the fire: Sean Combs, also known as Diddy. Now, it's essential to remember that these are theories, not facts. The whispers suggested Diddy had a hand in the shooting, but there's no concrete evidence to support this. Some say he hired the hit, while others believe he was merely aware of the impending attack. The theories are as numerous as they are diverse. Yet, the question remains: did Diddy have any involvement in Tupac's death? As we dive deeper into the details of that night, the waters only get murkier. Witnesses recall seeing Diddy at the scene, while others vehemently deny his presence. Some claim to have overheard conversations linking Diddy to the shooting, while others are convinced these are merely fabrications, born out of the intense rivalry between the East and West Coast rap scenes. What we know for certain is that Tupac Shakur, a prominent figure in hip-hop, was gone, leaving behind a legacy and a mystery that continues to baffle us. The theories, the speculations, the whispers in dark corners, they all add to the enigma that was Tupac's untimely demise. In the wake of Tupac's death, the theories began to swirl. The hip-hop world was plunged into a state of confusion, shock, and sadness. The loss of a leading voice in the industry left a void that sparked an avalanche of speculation and conspiracy theories. One of the most prominent theories points the finger at Diddy. As the story goes, Diddy, who was Tupac's chief rival at the time, was said to have orchestrated the hit on Tupac. The theory suggests that the rivalry between the two artists, which had been simmering for years, had finally boiled over into a deadly confrontation. But was this really the case? The fact is, there's a lack of concrete evidence to support this theory. Despite numerous investigations and countless hours spent poring over the details of that fateful night, no definitive link between Diddy and the murder of Tupac has ever been established. The theory, while intriguing and filled with drama, is just that: a theory. It's a narrative that fits neatly into the East Coast-West Coast rivalry narrative, but it lacks the hard evidence needed to be proven beyond a shadow of a doubt. This has led to a never-ending debate among fans and critics alike. Some firmly believe in Diddy's involvement, citing his rivalry with Tupac, and the tension between the East Coast and West Coast as enough reason to suspect foul play. Others, however, argue that the theory is nothing more than an urban legend, a sensationalized story born out of the chaos and confusion that followed Tupac's death. In the end, the question remains: who was responsible for Tupac's death? Was it a result of the East Coast-West Coast rivalry? Was it an act of revenge from a scorned rival? Or was it just a tragic case of being in the wrong place at the wrong time? So, did Diddy have a hand in Tupac's death? The truth, it seems, is as elusive as ever.